There's a brain teaser that's been upsetting people for a half century now. It's a scenario based on an old game show called Let's Make a Deal, hosted by Monte Hall. In one of the games, Monte would ask a contestant to choose from three doors. Behind one door is the prize of a new car, and behind the other two are gag prizes called zonks, which would be something like a goat. The contestant would pick a door, which would give them a 1 in 3 chance of winning the car. To draw out the drama, Monte would then open up one of the other two unchosen doors, revealing a goat. He would then ask the contestant if they wanted to choose the other door or keep their original choice. The question is, are your odds better if you change to the other door? Or does it not matter, and you are just as well off to keep your original choice? Here's the breakdown of the situation. Initially, your chance of winning is just 1/3. So, statistically, your initial choice will be wrong most of the time. However, in the moment of drama, Monte then reveals a door which will always contain a gag prize. He doesn't pick the door to reveal at random, but will always choose a door with a goat, and that's the key. Because now, more information has been revealed. We now know for certain of a wrong choice. The original choice had a 1 in 3 chance of being right. But now the choice is reduced to just 2 doors. Choosing the other door has a 1 in 2 chance of being correct, which is better than the original 1 in 3 chance. So, statistically speaking, you're better off to shift your choice to the new door. The strategy of changing your selection to the other unopened door will be correct most of the time. Even though that's how the odds work, I get it how that might absolutely not seem right. This has been a point of argument for many smart people for decades. It's possible to work it out in your head one way, then turn it around so the other way makes more sense. As opposed to showing a bunch of traditional diagrams to prove this, I'm going to illustrate it by example. I made a simulation of the game that will randomly place a car and goats behind doors, and then randomly choose a door. Repeating this simulation over and over with different randomized values can show us the odds. As a warm-up, here's a scenario with just 2 doors and 1 unchanging choice. I'm using Autodesk Maya software, and this is an expression written in its MEL scripting language. Here's my code with annotations if anyone who knows some coding wants to see how this works. Running this scenario 100 times, we get about 50 wins, or a 50% success rate to win the car, as we would expect. So here's the Monte Hall problem. We'll run one version of the scenario that will always keep the initial choice, and another that will always change selections after the reveal, and see who wins more often. Here's how it works. Once the items are randomly placed, and you choose a random door, there's a 1 in 3 chance of choosing the car. With the strategy of not changing doors, the odds of initially choosing the car are 1 in 3, and those odds don't change, since the revealed door doesn't matter. After 100 iterations of the game, you win about 33 cars. With the strategy of always changing doors, you again start with a 1 in 3 chance of choosing the car. If you do initially choose the car, it doesn't really matter which goat door is then revealed, because once you change doors, you'll be choosing the other goat and lose. So the changing door option starts with a 1 in 3 chance of losing. But if you do choose a goat initially, there is only one door that can be opened to not reveal the car. The other goat must be revealed, leaving the car as the other hidden option. Meaning that if your initial choice was a goat, changing the decision after the reveal guarantees that you will win the car. There's a 2 in 3 chance of initially choosing the goat, meaning the option to change will be successful 2/3 of the time. As the simulation runs, we can see that in 100 iterations of the game, with the strategy of always switching the chosen door, you'll win 2/3 of the time. So you're doubling your chances of winning if you always change doors. This experiment gives us a view into not just logic, but our perception of it. For many smart people, this logic seems annoyingly untrue. It's almost part of human nature to reject logic when it doesn't feel right. In fact, a study in 2010 presented pigeons with the Monte Hall problem, in which the birds had to choose between 3 doors to obtain a prize of grain. they found that the pigeons were able on their own to figure out and use the optimal strategy of consistently switching doors. If you compare this to humans who often fail to do this, even with extensive training, it shows that logic can sometimes be difficult for us to accept. So that's the challenge of logical thinking. We might discover truths that can uncomfortably disrupt the way we currently understand our world.